EOS R1 mirrorless digital camera. Rumored stats. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I'm Canon EOS photographer Randall M. Roof. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about the Canon EOS R1 specifications. Of course, these are all rumors, so take it for what it is. Rumors. I'm currently shooting with the Canon EOS 7D, and my primary lens is the 40mm 2.8 lens, which is a nice little lens. I wish it was the 24-70 2.8, but I can't afford it. And I also have a 28-300 Phoenix lens, which is more of a generic lens, but for some of those far away shots, it's not too bad. Could be better, but not complaining. I'm glad to have what I have, and I thank the good Lord above for the equipment and abilities to do what I do with what I've got. So, and I'm very thankful for that. Now, having said that, would I like to have the R1 when it comes out, and the 28-70 2.0 lens? Absolutely. So let's talk about what actually the R1 is supposed to have. Again, these are just rumors, so again, take it for what it is. Approximately 85 megapixels, which is amazing. Again, wow. A global shutter, CMOS imaging sensor, which is amazing. Now keep in mind, with my Canon EOS 7D, I'm shooting at 18 megapixels when I use full resolution. So 85 would be, so let's go to the second point, and that's 85 megapixels at 20 frames per second. That to me is amazing. Maybe to a lot of sports, professional sports shooters, I would think even for them, that's, for the most part, pretty amazing, at 85 megapixels. Or you can go to 21 megapixels, which is about what most Canon EOS 1DX Mark IIIs have right now, at 40, but they don't have it at 40 frames per second, that's for sure. So basically, it's that classic resolution versus speed. You got 85 at 20, or 21 at 40. So again, it's back to those days where you had the faster camera or the higher resolution camera, and they were about the same price, but you had to make the choice between a higher resolution and or a higher frame rate, depending on what kind of photography you were doing. But this is nice because it's the choices are in one camera, so that's definitely, in my opinion, will help sell it more, because instead of having two different cameras, you have one camera and you can make the choice. Okay, next thing is the full sensor, large quad pixel autofocus, which quad pixels are nice, autofocus is nice, because I wouldn't have a Canon camera without autofocus. The 15.5 EV plus of dynamic range, which is nice. Okay, next is the ISO 160, which I'm surprised it's starting at 160. I would think it would start around 100, but having said that, it goes all the way to 1,638,400, which probably is very unusable for anything but extreme, police work where you're doing something at night where it's real dark, or military work where it's real dark. In other words, most people are never going to use 1,638,400 ISO, but the fact that it can go that high, pretty nice. Again, I'm surprised it starts at 160, I'm surprised it doesn't start at 100, but again, not a big deal. A 5-axis IBIS up to 9 stops. I'm not sure what that is. I'll be honest. I don't know at all, obviously. I have no idea what a 5-axis IBIS up to 9 stops is. I don't know what IBIS is. Not a clue. So I guess I have to look at somebody else's video or look it up or Google it. I'm not going to Google it right now because I'm not in the mood to. 3.5-inch, 9.33 megapixel, 1280 nit, 10-bit, WCG RGB-OLED touchscreen with 128Hz of auto-exposure and autofocus. So basically what that means is you have a 3.5-inch screen and it's at 9.33 megapixels, which is basically all you really need to know. It's a touch screen, of course, which is nice. And the 120Hz, just the refresh rate. Of course, it's autofocus and auto-exposure. The 9.44 megapixel, 120Hz, super speed auto-exposure, autofocus, electronic viewfinder. That's pretty nice as well. Here's the kicker, though. And this is the problem why I will probably not be buying this camera. I mean, I would love to have this camera, don't get me wrong. And if I had $8,500, I know what I would buy. But I don't, I can't. Anyway, I won't cry too much. I've got my Canon EOS 7D, and it's obviously not going to be near as good. But for what I do, it's more than good. Do I wish I still, again, do I still wish I had $8,500 without the lens? Because that's going to be like $11,000 or $12,000 with the 28-70 lens. With taxes and shipping, it'd be around $12,000. That's not including extra cards and card readers and batteries. And so you're talking, by the time you consider the camera, the lens, the accessories, you're talking $15,000 with an $8,500 US price tag, plus tax and all that stuff. So I don't have that right now. But is this camera going to be amazing? Sure, it's going to be awesome. The Canon EOS 7D that I have, it's amazing. It doesn't do as good on autofocus and video mode as I'd like, but overall, it's a pretty good camera. This is obviously the R1 when it comes out. Whether these specs are true or not, it's going to be an amazing camera. It's going to be an amazing step up. It's going to be the first one series Canon camera with the improved distance from lens to sensor and the RF mount. So, again, do I wish I had it? Yeah. Am I going to get it? Hopefully. But I don't know how. If I do, I don't know how I'm going to do it. So, anyway, just want to make a little video. A lot of other people do it. So I'm like, yeah, why not? I've got nothing else to do right now. Well, that's not completely true, but anyway. At the end of this video, I'm going to leave my name and address. If you want to send me one, if you got more money, you want to do it, and you're like, how can I help someone with this camera? I'll leave my name and address. I don't expect anybody to do it, but, can't hurt to try. So, with that in mind, I just want to say thanks for watching. Have a good day, and God bless you.